I recently got this new face cam. The thing is, it's only 720p, 30fps. And this is how it looks without any lighting. So the only light that is coming on my face is natural lighting. I can see sun right over there. And I'm sorry for the disturbance because I have opened the window. But that's how it looks without any lighting. And this is how it looks with the lights. So currently I'm not having a very professional lighting system, but I'm using my phone's camera and two of the tube light. So yeah, it's pretty good. So the answer is very clear. Lighting wins. Thanks for watching the video, guys, and I will meet you in the next one. Have you ever noticed that even the worst camera performs really good at beach? So the reason for that is whenever you give any camera a good amount, a decent amount of light, I don't know what I'm saying. If I closely zoom on this painting, you can see the difference. What would you choose? Should I buy a better camera or should I upgrade my lighting even further? Well, that's what this video is all about. Hey guys, so welcome back to another Rumor Place video. So finally, after a few weeks, I have got time to record a video. And this video is all going to be about camera and lighting. Which one should you choose? And upgrading the camera is better or upgrading the lighting is better? The lighting comes with its own benefits and cons. Same goes with the camera. And you know, it really depends on the situation. And today we are going to talk about this topic in detail. And if you haven't subscribed yet, then please make sure to subscribe. Hit the like button and let's start with the video. And guys, now I'm using my phone's front camera. Let's say you don't have any face cam and you're searching for a camera to join Google Meeting or Teams and for the office work. At that point of time, I would recommend you, at least from my experience, because I've been using this PC for 1 year and I didn't had any camera as such. So I was still recording video, I was still using my phone as a webcam, and there are tons of applications that you can use for recording your phone as a webcam. This thing also has a downside that your phone won't be free, so you always got to attach the phone as a camera, and that's actually a pretty big downside for me, since most of the people usually use both their phone and their PC for doing their work. At least I do for recording my YouTube videos. I have charged on my phone and I use PC as well for recording the video. But then whenever I use webcam, I can't use my phone to read charts. So yeah, it might be helpful to buy a cheap webcam for not recording any YouTube videos. And the webcam that I have bought is, I think, cost around under 1000 rupees, like 800, 900. So you can buy a webcam under 1000 rupees if you only want a webcam for like need purposes. You don't have any interest and you don't want to record anything. Just buy a simple webcam, and you can always upgrade your lighting to make it look better, because now I'm recording with my phone's webcam. It's not really great in any sense, but the lighting that I'm using is really flourishing the camera quality, even though it's not the world's best camera. So yeah, that would be really helpful to buy a cheap webcam if you don't have any YouTube purposes. Okay, let's say you have a YouTube channel. And of course, if you're a very big YouTuber, you won't be watching this video. And if you're watching, then please make sure to give me a shout out or something. Okay, I think that's too much to ask. But what I'm saying is that if you are planning to do YouTube, or if you just want better webcam, you want your impression to be good in your Google meeting and Teams, then just go with a Logitech webcam. You can go with any webcam, 1000 or something. But I would say personally, if I had to make a choice, and I'm just starting on the YouTube, I'm not really a big YouTuber, I will personally buy cheap Logitech webcam, like at something around 2000 rupees, and then I can upgrade my lighting to make it look really better. Now coming on to the lighting. Now the lighting is really key to making everything look better. Whenever you go to beach, because it's so bright there, every photo looks really clean. So of course you can't bring a sun in your home, so you will need a better lighting. But the lighting from different sources would cast shadows, and that's what we don't want. And you can see at this picture how you can see shadows because of the not so carefully placed sources of lighting. So yeah, lighting has its own flaws, because of course if you're using a home lighting, then that's well and good, but if you're buying a lighting, it consumes a lot of space, and if you're using a laptop, you want a portability, you don't want all this thing, just buy a good looking webcam. But if you're on a PC, and personally if I'm sitting on a PC, I would buy a better lighting with a cheap camera, because already lighting could be achieved with normal home lighting. That's all your job, like 2 or 3 lighting, and then you can invest around 500 or 1000 rupees to buy a better lighting, and then that would make your video quality look better, sharp, crisp, but it won't improve the video quality as such. Like the 480p webcam with better lighting can't look as great as a 1080p webcam with mediocre lighting. So of course you can't improve the lighting like drastically with a very good camera quality, with drastically with good lighting, but you can really help. And if you're having a cheap webcam and you are like not impressed with the quality, try to improve your lighting. That might help. According to me, this webcam, I got this as a gift. It works really great in the small frame, like I showed you in the earlier part of the video, like whenever I'm doing a live stream or doing a video gameplay. So in those cases the camera is really small, you know, the camera frame is really small, like on the left hand side. So at that certain scenario, the 480p webcam works great. It's cheap as well. But when we go to the full screen video like this one, so for that phone webcam is good. And I'm currently not even using my phone's back camera. The front camera works fine because I can see my face, I can see my expression. So I usually like to use, currently I can see my video on the PC itself and this particular phone. So it works really great. I get the idea of, am I fitting in the frame, how is my expression and all. So yeah, that's the thing. So personally, coming on to the conclusion. So my conclusion is, buy a cheap webcam if you can. Try to buy a cheap webcam, and if you already own one, try to improve your lighting. Of course, the thing is, opinion differ with person to person, so some people might find this video helpful, and I'm glad I could help you, and some people would still want a better camera because lighting isn't helping, and that could be a case, then you can buy a one. But personally, if you compared camera with lighting, in most of the scenario, lighting is a great option. It's cheap as well, it does the job very well, whereas compared to camera, the webcams are really really expensive nowadays, because they do a lot of advertising. So webcam has a lot of flaws as well. The phone camera works fine if you can, if you have a very old phone that you are not using, you can use it as a webcam, that works fine. And yeah, that's it. So thank you guys so much for watching this video. If you like this video, then please make sure to subscribe. And yeah, if I zoom into this thing, you can see the difference between 1080p. Yeah, the 1080p works fine. I have one lighting less. So yeah, it's still working fine. So thank you guys so much for watching. If you like this video, then please make sure to subscribe. Hit the like button, and I will meet you in the next one. Thank you guys so much for watching.